Now that we already have the list of contacts showing here in the app, we can continue the development. Let's look back at the design of the app that we have here in Miro and see what we need to develop now. Okay, we have this list of contacts, and as we can see, we need to add the search and the drop-down filter to filter the contacts that we have in the list. So let's go back to our screen where we have the list of contacts, free some space, and then put these controls here. Okay, so we have a label, a text input, another label, and a drop-down. Going back to the app, I'm going to select the gallery and free some space here in the top by resizing the gallery. Okay, now I don't want to put much effort into aligning and sizing the controls. So, given the previous class that talks about the container, I'm going to use a vertical container here. Let's go to the insert pane and then select the vertical container here under the layouts, or we can search this search bar. So vertical container. Okay, let's click on vertical container and resize it. So we have the vertical container occupying the space we have at the top. Okay, now, as I mentioned, we need a label, a text input, a label, and a drop down. Let's insert them. So I'm going to go to insert. Then we have text label. Now let's go again to insert, select text input, insert another text label, and then insert. We have here in the input the drop down. We also have combo box, that's a different control, but in this case, let's use the drop down, that's the simpler one. Okay, selected the drop down, and we have the four controls here. If I select the container, I can make them already stretch to the width of the container all at once by selecting here in the horizontal properties the stretch button. So I'm going to click here. Everything already is stretching. Now let's add some padding in the container. So I have the container selected. Let's do some top padding. I'm going to use 16. Also to the bottom, to the left, and to the right. Okay, now we have a nice padding of the controls. Let's select the text labels. I'm going to click in the first one, press Ctrl and click in the second one, and change the font weight to semi-bold. I can also align the text to the bottom, so the text will be closer to the inputs, giving that sensation of a group, that's the label and the input. So with the two labels selected, here we have the vertical align, and I'm going to put bottom. So the texts will be closer of the inputs. If I click out of them, I can see it better. Let's change the texts. So the first one is search by name, and the second one is search by department. With the first one selected, I'm going to put here in the text, search by name. And the second one, let's change the text to search by department. Okay, very good. Now this text input has this property that's the default value, that's written text input. If I play the app, or if a user plays the app, this text will be here and the user needs to delete this text to type something. So that's not very adorable. We can then remove the default property here. So just go to the default and delete what's in there. If we want to put some placeholder here, some hint text, we can select, and then in the hint text property, we can type the text we want to show in there. So for example, type the username. Now, if I play the app, since it's a hint text, once I click here, this text will disappear and I can already type. So for example, Kujimar. Right now, the text doesn't do any filtering in the gallery because it's not enough just to add the controls that the filter will happen. We need to know the formulas and apply them to the gallery control. But before doing that, let's rename the controls now. We changed the texts. Let's now rename the controls. The first one, instead of label 2, I will rename to LBL search name title. The second label, instead of label 3 in my case, I will rename to LBL search department title. The first text input I will rename to TXT name, and the dropdown I will rename to DRP department. Nice. Now we need to make the search work, and also in the future add the departments here instead of these numbers that doesn't make any sense right now. So in the next video we are going to learn how to apply the search in a gallery from a text input. I see you in there. Bye bye.